How are you, my learner? I welcome you to Ambassador Foundation, whereby today we are going to see how we can prepare some of the compounds of nitrogen. Last time, we were able to see isolation of nitrogen from air, and today I would like us to see how we can prepare nitrogen from in the laboratory. You know, apart from isolating nitrogen from air, the other way around, we can prepare it in the lab. And specifically today, I want us to see how we can prepare nitrogen gas, how we can prepare nitrogen 1 oxide gas, how we can prepare nitrogen 2 oxide gas, and lastly, we see how we can prepare nitrogen 4 oxide gas. Nitrogen 2 oxide, we call it nitrogen monoxide 1 oxide. And this one is nitrogen, it has two atoms of oxygen, so we can, just the same way, we can say carbon dioxide, we can say nitrogen dioxide, because it has two oxides of oxygen. And as you can see, the difference is that all of them, they have nitrogen, the difference is the number of oxygen atoms. Nitrogen gas has no oxygen atoms, and remember, it exists as a molecule. Nitrogen 1 oxide gas has only 1 oxygen atom. Nitrogen 2 oxide has 1 oxygen atom, but the number of nitrogen here are 1, and in nitrogen 1 oxide there are 2. Then in nitrogen 4 oxide, the number of oxygen atoms are 2. So we are going to see each one of them. And what I would like to, I want to make this easier for you, because most of the students, they are confused. Now, how can we master preparation of 4 gases, and still there are other gases that you are supposed to prepare? This one, it follows a certain pattern that I would like you to know from today. You will find that nitrogen gas and nitrogen 1 oxide, their way of preparation is almost similar. Then the two here, their way of preparation, the method of preparation is almost similar. Let me take you back to nitrogen gas and nitrogen 1 oxide gas. First of all of them will decompose a compound which only differ by 1 oxygen atom. We have a compound here. This one, we call it ammonium nitrite. Then, we have 4 here. Then this other one, this one is ammonium nitrate. The difference is the number of oxygen atoms. Nitrite has 2 oxygen atoms, nitrate has 3 oxygen atoms. Now, this is the way forward. If you want to prepare a nitrogen gas, you decompose. This one, when you decompose, this one, when you decompose, you get nitrogen gas. When you decompose this one, you will get nitrogen 1 oxide gas. So it is very simple. You simply master that one, because ammonium nitrite, then ammonium nitrate. When you decompose this, you will get nitrogen 1 oxide gas. So that is what now you are supposed to know. You just decompose, and then the other thing is, you know how to write the equation of decomposing ammonium nitrite. I cannot do everything for you. As a student, just know how to write equation when you decompose ammonium nitrite and ammonium nitrate. In one of the broader forms, there will be nitrogen gas if you decompose ammonium nitrite. If you decompose ammonium nitrate, there will be nitrogen 1 oxide gas. That is it. I will still show you the diagram for this. The other one is that preparation of nitrogen 2 oxide and nitrogen 4 oxide. And let me tell you something. When you want to write the chemical formula of nitrogen 1, nitrogen 2 oxide, and or nitrogen 4 oxide, we know very well that nitrogen has a valency of 3. But now, when you are writing nitrogen 4 oxide, the way I'm saying it, nitrogen 4, you see now that the nitrogen has a valency of 4, you will get this. When you are writing nitrogen 2, you assume now that nitrogen has a valency of 2, you will get this formula. And when you are writing about nitrogen 1 oxide, you assume that nitrogen has a valency of 1, and you will simply get this formula. Now, let me take you how we can prepare nitrogen 2 oxide, which I have said, this is also called nitrogen monoxide, and nitrogen 4 oxide, which I have said, is also called nitrogen dioxide. Now, we use the same reagents, but there is something that differs. Both of them will require copper metal, which should be reacted with nitric acid, which is aqueous. That is what you require in both cases. But now the difference is this. When preparing nitrogen 2 oxide, we use dilute nitric 5 acid. Dilute nitric 5 acid. But when preparing nitrogen 4 oxide gas, we use concentrated nitric 5 acid. There is a diagram here showing how we can prepare either nitric 5 or, nitrogen 1, 2 oxide and nitrogen 4 oxide. This is it. We have dilute nitric 5 acid and we have the copper tannins. The difference now comes in either if it is dilute or concentrated. Gong. We always talk of gong nitric 5 acid. If maybe you are trying to answer a question and you have seen that it is dilute, the gas here will be nitrogen 2 oxide. But if it is concentrated, the gas produced will be nitrogen 4 oxide. Nitrogen 4 oxide gas. So now, just play your mind with either dilute or concentrated. The way I told you, when preparing either nitrogen gas or nitrogen 1 oxide gas, you either play with nitrite, ammonium nitrate, or ammonium nitrate. It is very simple. So you master one for two. So that is it now. And what I'd like to say to finalize on this, because you can see it is just cheap. You know, chemistry is cheap. Don't make your mind to, or your head to be that hard. So both they have different properties. What I could say, nitrogen is not always reactive because of the bonds. Nitrogen gas, you know, it exists as a molecule. Two atoms of nitrogen, and in each case, it has three covalent bonds, three shared pair of electrons. Now, this one, for this to react, these bonds must be broken. Therefore, it makes it to be inert. The meaning of the word inert is it is unreactive at normal or room temperature. Though it can react with metals like magnesium. Magnesium plus nitrogen gives you magnesium nitride. Magnesium nitride. Then nitrogen one oxide gas also it can react with some metals which are more reactive than nitrogen. For example, in the reactivity series of elements, any element that is above nitrogen is able to reduce nitrogen nitrogen monoxide to nitrogen gas. Likewise to nitrogen 4 and nitrogen 2. They can be reduced by any element, most of the metals which are above it in the reactivity series. Again, concerning these gases here, some of their physical properties are the same. For example, the first three are colorless, you cannot see them, but nitrogen 4 oxide is a brown gas. You can see brown gas. And mostly, when you are asked about physical properties, these are properties that you can detect with your five common sense. Maybe you can even see, you can smell. For example, when we talk of nitrogen 1 oxide gas, you can smell it. It has a pleasant smell. That's why sometimes back, so many years ago, it was used as an anesthetic. When you were being undergoing surgery, you know, it is called a laughing gas. Laughing gas, left, right, yeah? You know, you may think I mean another laughing, but I mean laughing gas. What do I mean by the word laughing gas? When you were undergoing surgery, then immediately you are to come out of your unconsciousness, now to be conscious, they expose you to nitrogen monoxide. And because it has that pleasant smell, you will wake up laughing. I don't know how, but it's true. You wake up laughing. So now, next time you will see now the properties. How do these gases react with other elements, with the metals, with non-metals, and with acids? And for today, just get contented for that. And I had a diagram here showing how we can prepare either nitrogen gas or nitrogen 1 oxide gas. Now check here. The diagram is very clear. This one is nitrate. So the gas produced has to be nitrogen 1 oxide gas. This gas has to be nitrogen 1 oxide gas. But if the examiner would tell you now, you know, to decompose is to break down substance by use of heat or acids. But in this case, we are using heat. Now, if this ammonium nitrate, for example, I change here to be I, then I will be forced to change here to be nitrogen gas. So you see, from nitrogen to nitrogen oxide, they have a common way of preparation. Nitrogen 2 and nitrogen 4, they have a common way of preparation. That is laboratory preparation. Next time we will talk much about manufacture. I will also tell you the difference between preparation and manufacturing. Otherwise, I don't have much. Thank you for watching this clip. Ensure you subscribe to Ambassador Foundation. Thank you.